Welcome to Crypto Jargon. In this episode, we look at the following terms: block, block size, block height, block time, block timestamp, and block reward, all in relation to blockchain, of course. This episode is sponsored by Ledger, the maker of the best hardware wallets on the market. To find out more about it, check out the description of the video where you will find the link and my tutorials on the Ledger Nano S and Ledger Nano X devices. So let's start with what is a block. It is in fact just a file with digital data. Mostly that would be the most recent transactions of a cryptocurrency, but it could also be other digital data depending on the blockchain. As new blocks are created and processed, they are interlinked with the previous blocks in what is known as a blockchain. Block size. As you can easily guess from the name, this is the capacity of each of these blocks, aka files, and that will vary from cryptocurrency to cryptocurrency. For instance, Bitcoin's block size capacity for the most part of its lifespan has been 1 megabyte, which some people do not agree with, and they branched off in 2017 creating Bitcoin Cash, which now has blocks of 32 megabytes size. Block height refers to the number of blocks connected together in the blockchain. It is the number of blocks between itself and the Genesis block. Genesis block is the first block. It has a height of 0. In other words, we can say that it's the block number in the blockchain sequence, although the correct term is not number but height. Block time is literally the time it takes to generate a new block on a blockchain. That is different for every cryptocurrency. For instance, with Bitcoin, that is every 10 minutes. For Litecoin, it is every 2.5 minutes, while for Ethereum, it varies, but it's usually under 15 seconds. Block timestamp is different than block time. It is the record of when a block was created and transactions were processed. Every transaction also has a timestamp. This is the moment the transaction was processed. So this is the difference between block time, which is the time it takes for a block to be created, and block timestamp, which is the actual time it was created. And block reward. This is basically the payoff, the reward given to a miner who has successfully calculated the hash in a data block during the mining process. The mining is explained in a different episode of this series, so make sure you check that out. Block rewards can be a mixture of coins and transaction fees depending on the policy used by the cryptocurrency in question. With Bitcoin, for instance, this reward is halved every 4 years, and it started as being 50 coins per block in 2008, then in 2012 it was halved to 25 coins, in 2016 it became 12.5 coins, and in 2020 it will be halved again to 6.25 coins per block. This is programmed in the Bitcoin code, and it is intended in order to distribute less supply over time, thus reducing the risk of deflation in value. This is how I can tell you that the last full Bitcoin will be mined in 2032, and the last Satoshi will be mined in the distant future. The year is 2140. If you like this video, make sure you share it with someone else who will also benefit from watching it. Give me the like or leave a comment below the video. I'd like to hear your feedback. And thanks for watching. I'm gonna see you in the next episode. Enjoying this content? Why not grab a copy of my book, Crypto Jargon A to Z, the most thorough dictionary that exists to date, with over 700 definitions of acronyms, trading slang, and all the crypto terminology you need. Just go to ojjordan.com/cryptojargon and grab your digital copy today. Thank you.